Troy Green.
Welcome to Specs Profile. I'm Kelly Whitman. Today we have a lot to talk about, and while you enjoy the show, I will be enjoying my picnic. Spring is finally here, and as the days are getting warmer, the NHL playoffs are heating up as well. With another 100-point season under their belt, the Detroit Red Wings are preparing for their run at the Lord Stanley's Cup. Our very own Dan Griffin has more on just how they plan to do that.
Our Detroit Red Wings are in the playoffs for the 17th consecutive season, the longest set streak in professional sports. And any diehard fan will tell you, that streak is no fluke.
In that time, Detroit has 11 Central Division championships, 3 Stanley Cups, and 5 President's Trophies. And this year, the Wings are well on their way to doing it all over again. But this season has been no cakewalk, with some long-term injuries to some very key players. Dominic Hasek has been in and out of the lineup all season, leaving Chris Osgood and 23-year-old Jimmy Howard to fill the void between the pipes. With key defensemen such as Lidstrom and Rafalski out of the lineup at once, the Red Wings have been forced to call up a slew of players from Grand Rapids, such as number 14 Derek Meach, who's played in 30 games and picked up 3 assists in their absence. The Red Wings have even gone back in time and picked up some faces of old, as Darren McCarty finds himself donning the winged wheel for the second time in his 16-year career. He's only played 6 minutes since returning to Motown in February, but the reestablishment of the famed grind line of McCarty, Maltby, and Draper should be a key asset to Detroit's run to an 11th Stanley Cup championship.
Now, with the first round of the Stanley Cup playoffs starting this week, and with guys like Cronwall and Cleary back on the ice, and with the Dominator finally healthy and defending the team's honor between the pipes, this Red Wings team is looking for nothing less than to bring Lord Stanley's Cup back home to Hockey Town.
Al Sabota is building operations manager at the Joe. He's also been the Zamboni driver for Red Wings games for the past 30 years. But he is probably best known for his part in a well-known Detroit playoff tradition that started way back in the Gordie Howe era.
How do you keep a hold of the octopus?
It's the strong arms that I have, you know. Fingers here, you just get a good grip of it, make sure you don't let it go. It's some tradition that we've had for many years. We just try to deal with it as it comes. There isn't as many as it has been in the past.
Specs grad Sean Beligian is a sports talk show host on AM 1130 WDFN The Fan.
Let's go to Tracy. Tracy, what's up? You're on Sports Radio.
And he's been taking calls about Detroit's chances against possible first-round matchups against teams like Nashville and Vancouver.
One of the drawbacks about the Red Wings in playoff years gone by is the old bit had developed that if you push the Red Wings, they're not going to push back, especially come playoff time. And I think what teams found out, in particular San Jose last year, is that when you push the Red Wings, they are going to push back.
If you're not lucky enough to actually get into the Joe, Hockey Town Cafe is right around the corner on Woodward Avenue. This is a terrific place to kick back a few cold ones and enjoy the game on one of their many 62-inch HD TVs. With the Red Wings dominating their opposition for a better part of this season, it should make for another great playoff run right here in the Motor City, as well as an increase in octopi sales. I don't get it, but I love playoff hockey. For Specs Howard School of Broadcast Arts, I'm Dan Griffin.
Thanks, Dan. Don't even think about going anywhere, because coming up next, we are going to tell you what it takes to become the next RTV Rock Girl.
On the field or on the court, you want to play the best. You want to be the best. You gotta have the best. Only one stands above the rest. Tense games require intense equipment. What's your Wilson?
What's the scariest six-letter word you can hear?
Cancer. Of all the major health problems in the world today, nothing is more frightening than cancer. You can help save lives by becoming a member of the American Cancer Society. As a member, your generosity is helping to fund new treatment and research, so donate today at cancer.org or call 1-800-ACS-2345 and give the gift of hope. The life you save could be your own.
Welcome back to Specs Profile. Ladies, while the guys enjoy the hockey playoffs, there's something for you to look forward to. One of the top rock stations in America is in search for a new rock girl. But how do they decide who it should be? Who has the personality and the curves to represent WRIF? Well, every year, girls from all over the place gather to find out who will become the newest face of rock and roll. Carissa, do I have what it takes?
Well, Kelly, you might have what it takes to be the new RTV Rock Girl, but you're going to have some tough competition. I'm at Malarkey's Irish Sports Pub, where the RTV is holding their fourth and final casting call for their contest to become the new RTV Rock Girl. A slew of local girls have come in hopes of becoming the new face of the legendary rock station 101.1 WRIF, the RTV. Every year, the RTV puts together a huge event to find their new RTV Rock Girl. This year's lucky winner will score a $40,000 salary, an on-air position at the RTV, VIP access at all the local events and concerts. Plus, the winner will also star in her own RTV calendar. But what does it really take to be a RTV rock girl?
Well, first of all, you've got to have a liver like a champion to hang with these rock stars and pound away. No, I'm kidding. We're looking for the perfect balance between professional and sexy.
Her presentation is key, along with great speaking skills and a charming personality.
I think it's going to take somebody who is going to be up a lot of challenges, definitely can be outgoing and out there and just ready to have a good time.
Each girl is interviewed individually to see if she has the personality to be a voice at the top rock station in America.
Just having our call letters on your resume, if broadcasting is any interest to you at all, gets you jobs because we are world famous, and the fact that in the entire country, the rock stations do not get the ratings that RTV does, which makes us number one in the country.
They will also participate in a quick photo shoot to show off their sex appeal. After the photo session, each contestant reads a sample traffic break to test her speaking skills. Of course, this isn't meant to be as serious or stuffy as a beauty pageant. The judges try to keep things light and fun, imitating the atmosphere at the RTV.
I think it'll change my life. It'll just bring new experiences my way, you know, do some things I've never done before.
It'd be a lot of fun to go out and just meet people and do a lot of different things.
I mean, right now, I'm definitely at a point in my life where I'm exploring a lot of new options, so it would change my life just by being able to get out there, meet a lot of rock stars, if you will, and just have fun and, you know, make people's days brighter with being on the radio every single day with the forecast and everything like that.
In the end, these girls are narrowed down from hundreds, but only one will be chosen. Tune in to 101.1 The RTV in May to find out your winner. With so many beautiful and talented girls, I don't know how the judges are going to decide a winner, but one thing's for sure, the new RTV rock girl will be sexy and talented. Tune in to 101 The RTV in May to find out the winner. I'm Carissa Baker in front of Malarkey's Irish Sports Pub, reporting for Specs Howard School of Broadcast Arts. While I slide into this next commercial break, we'll be back to tell you how to protect yourself from the bad sides of the internet.